Welcome to Right Click Education. In today's video, we will learn how we can implement Angular Material List in our Angular application. So, without any delay, let's get started. Open your Chrome, type Angular Material, click on search, open the first URL that you see. material.angular.io, which is the official website of Angular Material. You can see on the top navigation bar components, click on components. After clicking on component, you will get all the Angular Material elements in the side navbar. Today we will learn how we can implement list. Let's click on list. First we will see how it looks like. So if you see here, list is a container which wraps and formats a series of line items. Okay, so if you see, this is a list of items here, right? So in order to implement it in Angular Material, we need to first click on API and we need to copy this import, which is mat list module. Copy it, go to your VS Code, open app.component.ts, paste it. Now copy this mat list module and paste it to the import section of ng module. Paste it. Now the import part is done. Now we can implement the HTML part. Click on overview, click on view code. So you can see, right, this is the mat list, and inside mat list you have these mat list items, right? So let's copy it, go into your VS Code, open app.component.html. Here we will paste this. Okay, so the HTML is also done. Now let's compile the code. Type ng-serve in your command prompt. It will take a couple of seconds to compile the code. So the code has started to compile. After that we will open our Chrome with localhost 4200. So let's go to Chrome, open new tab, type localhost 4200. You can see, right, we have this list of items here, right? So whenever if you want to have the list of items, you can use Angular Material List. Okay, so this is the basic and simple implementation of Angular Material List. Let's see some other implementation and other use case in which we can implement mat list. Let's go to the official website, click on overview, scroll down. So this is the simple list, right? Now we will use navigation list. Okay, so in the navigation list, what we will do, we will use for loop to navigate through the list. Okay, so click on example, scroll down. We have implemented this basic list. Okay, now we will implement this list with sections. Okay, in order to implement it, click on view code, copy this, first let me copy the code, then I will explain how it is working. paste it here. Go to the official website again. Go to your TS file. They have created two arrays, one for folders, if you see, another is for notes. Okay, so we will do the same. But before that, they have created an interface with two properties, name and updated, which is of type date. So let's copy this first. Okay, go to our app.component.ts, scroll up, we will paste the interface here. So if you see this interface, this interface has two properties, one is name, another is updated. Okay, now let's again go back, copy this. Copy these both arrays and paste it here. Okay, so two arrays has been pasted. Now go to app.component.html. We have also done the HTML part. Let me explain once. So you have this mat list. So we have created a list in which we have two sections. One section is for folders, okay, and another is section is for notes. Okay, and inside that we have this mat list item. So it will basically give us a list of item, and we have used this ng for loop. So it is saying let folder of folders. So folders is an array. Okay, it has some elements into it. So we will loop over this folder array, and we will print every single element of it as an item. Okay, so this folder is an object which contains the name and updated property. Okay, so now let's go to our UI and see how it looks like. So if you see here, right, you can see this is a folder structure that we normally see in our phone or laptop, right? So we have created this one. We have created one folder which has a list of folders, which is saying photos and date, again recipes and date, work and date. So what we have done, we have used a for loop to loop through an array folders, and this array has objects, and that object has properties as name and date. Okay, so in this way we have implemented the Angular material list. Okay, so this was one good example on how to implement the Angular material list. Now we have one another two implementation, which is list with selection. So let's click on view code. Okay, we will copy this HTML code. Okay, go to your HTML, remove this code, paste it. So what we are doing, we are basically having list of items, and each item is selectable. Okay, so we are doing ng for on the mat list option. Okay, and type of source will be an array which will contain certain elements, and we will loop through this type of array, type of source array. Okay, so let's again go here on the official website, click on TS. If you see here, types of source is an array. copy this array. Okay, and let's go to our app.component.ts. We will remove this array that we have used previously. We will also remove this interface. This is of no use right now. So this is type of SUSE is an, a string array which has these all types of SUSE. Okay, so let's go to HTML. So this is a list of items and which is selectable. Okay, so let's go to our UI and see how it looks like. So if you see, right, these all items are selectable. So if I click here, the option selected is 1. If I click again, it says 2. So it is giving basically number of items that you have selected. Okay, so this is multi item selection. Okay, so this is a list in which we can select multiple items. Now we have another scenario where we have, if there is requirement to select any one of it, that can be also done. So list with single selection. Okay, for that what we need to do, for that we just need to do this multiple equals to false. So if multiple property is true, okay, here by default multiple is true, and if I put multiple equals to false, then you will see that we will be able to select only one element at a time. Do you see it? This option selected is 1 because it's giving the length of or how many items you have selected. So you can select only one item at a time, right? So these are the different implementation of Angular Material List. That's it for this video. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the more update. Thanks and have a nice day.